गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट स्ट्रीट लाइटिंग इन मॉड्यूल 4 फॉर ट्रैफिक इंजीनियरिंग. ओके, नाउ व्हेन वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट स्ट्रीट लाइटिंग, द रफ आइडिया वुड कम इन आवर माइंड व्हाट इज व्हाई स्ट्रीट लाइटिंग इज रिक्वायर्ड. ओके, सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी हैव टू स्टडी अबाउट द नीड ऑफ स्ट्रीट लाइटिंग. सेकेंड थिंग विच वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस टुडे इज फैक्टर्स अफेक्टिंग नाइट विजिबिलिटी. थर्ड वन इज some basic definitions are given to you. Fourth one, distribution of light. Fifth one is glare. And sixth one is how to control the glare from the luminaries. Okay. So first of all, street lighting. Okay. Now, street lightings are required for you road users to see the visibility and carriageway easily. Okay. Now, a majority of accidents, like India is a developing country. Okay. So road networks are not equal in all places. Okay, some roads are better and some roads are poor. So majority of accidents in India are caused at night. Okay, so and these accidents are caused due to the poor lighting. Okay, now if all the vehicles are used to drive with full headlights on. Okay, vehicles are provided with some full headlights, and if all vehicles are going with full headlights, what will happen? The road user or the vehicle user on the opposite side, who is coming on that side, will affect some glare or some higher light in his or her eye. Okay, so due to this, the judgment which he need to take, he cannot take. Okay, so due to this, it causes glare problems. Okay, and it may cause accidents. So for street lights, okay, in city where streets are provided, it is required to illuminate the carriageway. Okay, third one thing is improved night visibility. Okay, if we are providing street lighting, then night visibility can be improved for street lighting. Okay, and it ensures the comfort. Okay, it can ensures comfort, and it may give more confidence to the driver or road user. Okay, and fourth one, why it is required, street lighting. By providing better lighting, speed of traffic can be improved. Okay, if all the vehicles have a street lighting provided, then the road or that pavement or that carriageway is give confidence to the road user who is going to drive on that path. Okay, fifth one, the rate of highway accidents are more during night. As already said, in India road accidents occur at night are more and as compared to day. Okay, so if highway lighting is more required at intersections, at bridge sites or at level crossings. Okay, now if we are going to compare this street lightings with road rural roads and urban roads, we can see that a country like India have a wide network of rural roads. Okay, so as we know that rural roads are not as improved as compared to urban roads. Okay, due to some cost consideration and due to less and slow traffic movement on that roads. Okay, as compared to rural roads, in urban roads, what is needed, street lighting is more required because the density of population is high. Okay, in India, for urban roads. Okay, and the last one, the main purpose of a street lighting is to reduce the uncertainty of information. Now if some user is going on highway from one place to other place, if he want some kind of information that in which direction he can go to the one place to the other place, then he needs that information, and that information can be provided by providing signboards. Okay, or by providing indications that either he need to go through left, either he need to go through right. So this type of information can be provided on signboards, and to view these signboards we need a street lights. Okay, next one, which type of factors we need to consider for night visibility. First one is amount of light flux from the lamp. Okay, next one is distribution of flux. Okay, if that flux is provided from that lamp is uniform or not uniform, that will decide whether night visibility can be good or bad. Okay, size of a object, suppose the object which is coming for on that pavement or on that carriageway is either a car, either a bike, either a cycle. That type of size matters for night visibility. Okay, fourth one is brightness of an object. Okay, if that due to high glare, if its its light is coming directly to the road user or directly to the driver, it may cause accidents or some type of injuries to that person. Fifth one is background of brightness of background. Sixth one is reflecting characteristics of pavement surface. Now mostly pavements are made from asphalt or bitumen. Okay, to visible intersections we have provided some type of bright material on that pavement. Okay, and that reflecting characteristics can be improved by can be improved for night visibility. Seventh one is glare on the eyes of a driver. If the vehicle which is coming in the opposite direction has a more glare, then it may cause injuries to that person who is going in opposite direction. Next one is time available to see an object. If night visibility is easily available, then the person who is coming in other direction can easily take judgment or take decision that whether he is how much away from that other vehicle. Okay, so that time is required, and that time can be provided by providing the street lights. Okay, next one is some definitions. First one is luminous flux. What is luminous flux? It is a power given by source. Now this power is in the form of radiant power. Okay, so this power given is radiant power, and what amount or what power is given to by source is known as luminous flux. Okay, it is denoted by phi and its unit is lumen. Next one is lumen. What is lumen? It is equal to the amount of flux received on a particular surface area of 1 square meter. Okay, when the light source is placed at the center. Okay, so when the light source is placed at the center, the type of flux received on that surface for surface of 1 square meter of a sphere is known as lumen. Okay, next one is lumen intensity. Now flux emitted per unit angle. Okay, if flux is provided per unit angle, it is known as luminous flux. Next one is illumination. Now it is a measure of amount of light of flux, okay, which falls on the surface. Next term is luminance. Now luminance is either it is known as luminance or luminous intensity, is either emitted or reflected luminous intensity, either emitted or reflected per unit area of surface, is known as luminance. Now next one is glare. Now it is a type of condition in which there is a discomfort or a reduction in ability to see the object due to unsuitable distribution of light or in unsuitable distribution of luminance. Okay, and next one is luminaire. Now that is a house for one or more lamps consisting of a body or any reflector diffusers associated with luminaire. Okay, now distribution of a light. Okay, now what happens, output light will naturally radiate. Here we need to consider that there are two types of sources, which is either naturally or which is coming either naturally from the source or it will be radially from the source. Okay, now when the output of light source is naturally radiated uniformly from the point, then the equal intensity will come from all the direction, and this type of light will be insufficient and uneconomical when purpose is to direct the light for limited area like street pavements. Okay, now if we are going to distribute this light from naturally to radially, what will happen? The source with this source have also the equal intensity in equal all direction. Okay, but the amount of light falling on any particular point will be vary from the inversely of a square. Okay, square of a distance. Now what is happening when we are going to distribute light from naturally to radially? In naturally there is a insufficient or insufficient distribution of light and it is uneconomical. But when you are providing radially, then the amount of light or amount of light falling on particular point will be vary with the square of distribution. Okay, so these are the two things how distribution of light is provided. Now, good amount of flux is needed for the vertical angles. Okay, so if it is provided with some angle, it will cause formation of bright patches. Okay, next one, that is glare. Now, as I have already said, glare is one type of condition in which uncertain discomfort or reduction in ability is provided or occur. Okay, and it will cause unsuitable distribution of luminance. Now, amount of glare depends on five factors, that is brightness of glare source, angle of incidence with line of sight, level of illumination, area of glare source, and the last one is distance of glare source. Now, how can be luminance glare is controlled? Okay, it may be controlled by four ways. Either the increase in the height from height of mountains. Height of mountains means on which place we have placed this light or the source, and how much it is higher than the road pavement. Okay, that height should be provided in such a way that it will not cause a glare. Okay, second one is shielding of a light source. Third one is reducing the bright contrast of light source. Okay, and fourth one, now it is observed that when the light is emitted at angle less than 70 degree, then it will not reach to the driver's eye. Okay, because we have provided the shield. Okay, so these are the things which we need to consider when we are providing the when we are avoiding the glare from luminaries. Okay, if you students have any type of query, you can ask me by either mail or by writing comment at below. Okay, thank you.